Dr. Peter Levine has a warning for practitioners. You see, some practitioners make this one mistake when working with shame. It's well-intentioned, but it can drive clients into deeper feelings of shame. I'll let Peter explain.
What you see in shame is a very particular body posture and autonomic pattern. It's actually fairly similar to what you see in trauma, which is, I think, also one of the reasons, and I don't think people really appreciate how important this is, that whenever a person is traumatized, even if it wasn't in an interpersonal dynamic, an interpersonal relationship, because the posture of collapse is very similar in trauma as it is in shame, so you see the two of them fit together. You see that aversion of gaze, of looking away, of not wanting to be in contact with another person, because again, the pain of the shame is so devastatingly intense. Actually, there's some recent data. I was just teaching a class together with Bessel here in Zurich, Bessel van der Kolk, and some very interesting fMRI. If you show a person a picture of a friendly face, it lights up in the prefrontal cortex. So in other words, you say, okay, well, that's a friendly face. That's nice. That feels good. Now, if you play that same face to somebody who's traumatized, or I would say add, or is in shame, the frontal lobe actually shuts down, and the periaqueductal ray in the brainstem lights up, and that's the part of the brainstem that's used with fear and terror and paralysis, immobility. So if you, and this is a mistake often therapists make, they'll see that the client is in shame, and they try to be kindly, they try to be supportive, try to somehow make them feel better. But if you look back at that study, what happens when you do that is they just shut down even more and go even more into the shame. And then sometimes the therapist tries even more to get them out of the shame, which forces them back into the shame. So it's a difficult situation. And without understanding that, therapists can easily actually increase the level of shame. What I generally do when I work with a client is I work with two chairs, and they're kind of facing out at about 45 degrees. So the client can either be completely in their own space, or if they choose, they can make contact with me. But it's not, they're not forced to do that. Because if you're looking face to face, there's no way of getting away from that. So that's one of the things that therapists can do, is be aware of how they arrange their seating, and to be aware of then what happens if they try to make contact with a person who's in a state of shame,